Up next in the music room, some of the best in rock music.
We are the White Stripes, and this weekend we'll be on the music room.
I'm a sheets, I'm a labor's pain.
And from jazz to dance, follow the musical odyssey that is Nitin Soni.
I'll be good till I'm gone.
Plus a night out with a former sugar babe. That's all in the music room. On Track with Toyota, only on CNN.
I'm Angelique van der Bijl. Welcome as we open the door to some of the best in rock music. This week, the White Stripes make a big impression with Elephant. The genesis of an album, we follow Nitin Soni on a musical journey.
This is a track that I'm kind of working on. It's called Lately, and I'm kind of doing it for the next album.
And breaking through, a former sugar babe.
What you gonna give me? What you gonna give me?
Straight out of Detroit, Jack and Meg White make up the most exciting duo on the rock scene. As the White Stripes, they are redefining garage rock while dabbling in blues and American folk. Their most recent album, Elephant, was recorded in just 2 weeks at a studio in London. And it's a triumph of great songwriting and brilliant playing. TMR has been talking with the Stripes and visiting the studio where they brought it all together.
Stripes sort of had gotten a lot of attention in England all of a sudden, and the Strokes had just happened in England a couple months before. Nobody was really calling it anything, and they started asking us what we were, and we said garage rock because that's what all the bands in Detroit used to say, you know. I don't think anyone was using that term before since the 60s, really. But it's funny. I mean, who cares? It's just this term, I guess, you know. But it's just rawness, I think. Just rawness where it's no attention to detail. It's just the real rock and roll, you know.
I said it once before, but it bears repeating now.
The structure of the song doesn't really happen until Meg joins in, and that becomes the most important part. Childishness that she brings to it really gives it sort of its soul, or the White Stripes feeling to it. I think a song, when I write it on piano, I could go in a million different directions, I guess, if I had eight people in the band or whatever. It could be what she brings to it makes it, gives it its simplicity, I think.
Well, let the fool with the microphone can tell you what he loves the most. You know why you love that all if you're thinking of the Holy Ghost. You're thinking of the Holy Ghost.
We went over to England to the studio Toe Rag, and that we had heard about. We thought the sounds coming out of it were really interesting. The studio is really nice. It's sort of an old warehouse, and it's a small room set up like an old English beat studio, really, with black and white checkerboard. Liam Watson, who owns the place, he wears a white lab coat, and he's kind of a mad scientist.
For Jack and Meg, if I come in and, you know, change a microphone around or something, and I'm wearing the white coat, I think it makes them feel more confident, you know, about that I'm doing the right job.
We had great microphone techniques and old recording equipment. I think it's never been surpassed. I think it's really the pinnacle of technology for recording equipment.
This one here was a favorite of Jack's, which is the 4038 ribbon mic. Some of the other ones, Meg liked this one. Well, it sounded good on her voice, that one.
We wrote about four of those songs in the studio, actually. I mean, it's just better creatively in the studio because we don't get much time other than that really to work on a lot of things. So.
This microphone here is the Paul and Biscuit microphone that was used on the White Stripes record, and they ended up doing a song about it called Ball and Biscuit.
Let's have a ball and a biscuit, sugar, and take our sweet little time about it.
Most of the albums we've done, we rehearsed for maybe 1 or 2 weeks, go through them all, but not try to perfect them, just to sort of get them in our head. And then take it song by song when we record, you know, have each song have its own personality, if it's possible. That was a riff that I'd written in a soundcheck, a show we played in Australia. I thought it was sort of a James Bond theme. Like, if I got to write this next James Bond theme, that would be the riff I'd use, you know. So I was always playing that. I didn't really finish writing until we went to the record Elephant and sort of arranged it and finished writing the lyrics for it.
Taking their time right behind my back, and I'm talking to myself at night because I can't forget.
It's been very busy, but we're trying to go play in Australia and Japan and America and just sort of get that all out of the way and out of our system, and hopefully record a new record by the end of the year if we can, if we get a week off.
The White Stripes with what is surely one of the albums of the year.
And that's what's packed into the music room this week. Next time, an update on downloading. I'm Angelique van der Bijl. We'll leave you with a few more seconds of Detroit's finest.
You can hear a piano fall. You can hear me coming down the hall. If I can just see your pretty voice, I don't think I need to see at all. I don't think I need to see at all. Soft hair and a velvet tongue, I wanna give you what you give to me. And every breath that is in your lungs is a tiny little gift to me. It's a tiny little gift to me.